Should I shoot in RAW or in JPEG? When talking about RAW versus JPEG, it comes down to how much post-processing you are gonna do and where those pics are going to be used in. Are they going for magazines? Are they going for billboards? Are they going for posters? Or are they going online? All these questions will determine if you should shoot in RAW or in JPEG. As the name suggests, RAW images are lossless images. All the data are captured by the camera and they are uncompressed. So you get the total information about everything, starting from shadows to highlights to everything. On the other hand, JPEG, which stands for Joint Photographic Expert Group, is one of the most compressed format of images. So the information is less as captured by the camera. That's the reason they are small in sizes and you can fit more and more images into the memory card of your camera. But in RAW images, all the information that is captured is lossless. So when you are editing, when you are post-processing them in applications like Photoshop and Lightroom, you can easily tweak the exposure and temperature and every slider you wanna do so that you get the perfect of all. But while editing JPEG images, it's quite tougher because think it like a photocopy. Every time you save it, export it, and then again import it back and then make changes to it and again export it, the quality just decreases with every time you export it. But that's not the case with RAW. Since the RAW images are lossless, so every time you make changes to RAW images, it's quite like you are going back in time, and then while capturing the shot, you are just adjusting the exposure and everything in highlights and shadows in the camera itself, so that you get the lossless information and lossless amount of details in the images. It's very easy to adjust and fix the blown out part of the images and also the underexposed part of the images if the image is being captured in RAW. But in case of JPEG, it's very tough to fix it because whatever you do is just going to be on top of it and it's not gonna fix it with its original information. It's going to be on the top of that image and that top layer will try to fix that with its own algorithm. Then why is JPEG so much popular? This is because of its smaller size and easily accessible to almost all of the devices in the world. You can easily view the JPEG images from like your mobile, from your laptop, from a PC, from everything. But RAW images can't be viewed in normal photo applications. You need a Lightroom or applications like Photoshop to view them and export them. And after it's exported, then only you can deliver the images to your clients. And all this process takes some time. So this is the reason why JPEG is one of the most popular format and why still many people shoot in JPEG. But people like me and you who are taking their craft seriously, we can't lose information, right? We need all of the information the camera can capture in an image so that when we go into the post, we can easily fix our highlights and shadows or every perfect detail of it to get the perfect shot we need, to get the perfect exposure, to get the perfect clarity and everything. If you shoot in JPEG, the information is just lost forever. You can't recover it. You can't recover the data. So now you know in which format you should be shooting, and if you want to master what you are doing, then you should be shooting in RAW and make your pics, make your photographs the perfect shot, the perfect frame. So that's it guys for today's video. I hope the video was helpful for you. If you like the video, then don't forget to hit the like button. If you are new to this channel, then don't forget to hit the subscribe button below down there. That's it. See you soon in the next video. Till then, bye bye.